my job is not for everyone. I think that's really important. A lot of young girls see me and they you know, like what I look like, they like what my apartment looks like, they like my pets, and they think I want all that, but they don't really understand the job behind it, and they just see what I literally want people to see. My name is Ash Marie.
Hi.
And we are in my apartment.
Right, so let's go into my cam room.
I love my cam room. I feel like every cam model should have a space that they create for camming that is aesthetically pleasing as well as like comforting, because entertaining for a large audience is very nerve-wracking, and it takes me like 2 hours to get camera ready usually. HD web camera, bright lights, you know, and everyone's gonna be looking generally everywhere, so it might as well look great. While we're generally selling a sexual fantasy, much like in every other aspect of sex work, there's a personal aspect to it that, you know, you're usually in the cam model's own house. They're able to like generally talk about themselves and somewhat be honest, you know, maybe embellish a little bit to make themselves seem cooler. But I mean, and for the most part, and you know, you're getting a really personal experience. No matter if you're, even if you're going there only for the boobies and only for the booty, you're gonna leave with some personality whether you like it or not. There's no way that you can not see that the cam model is like a living, breathing, feeling person. I never actually thought that like he'd be helping me.
Yeah, no, like, that was not the intention, but like our professions kind of worked out. We work together really well because we're in a relationship, so that really helps.
Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I had never done any kind of like adult stuff in front of, like recording adult stuff in front of anyone.
I've never had anyone do adult things in front of me while I had to sit there and record it.
And I mean, he understands who I actually am, what I actually like, so there's no like outside expectation for me to be performing something that I don't, you know, want. Alright, so this is my booty mirror. I get real creative. I have a bunch of stuffed animals, which at 22 years old, I have trouble justifying. There's like coffee and spaghetti on him, and he has a hole in his crotch. It's very embarrassing. Being a traditionally attractive woman on the internet usually means that you're gonna get a lot of young girls following you. That's a new thing I had to get used to, especially with Instagram. There's so many little girls. So I try to keep a balance of reality in there, you know, that it's a tough job, that it requires a thick skin that I have definitely had to learn to grow, because I did not have a thick skin before camming. That was, or before social media. Being a feminist on the internet is pretty much means that you're gonna get a bunch of men that are disagreeing with you purely on that alone, or harassing you purely for that reason alone. So my being a cam model on top of being a feminist, which has put a huge, huge target on my forehead. I think the most common thing associated with cam models, like the thing that you assume, is they must be so comfortable with their body. I, like any other normal human being, have self-esteem issues growing up. I started losing a bunch of weight because I have health issues, I have digestive issues that we don't know exactly what they are yet. Doctors are kind of stumped. I have received 2 notifications today from Instagram that a friend is very concerned that I have an eating disorder. Apparently this friend can't read because I posted literally 2 days ago about my health issues. So if you could stop getting my photos removed for being too skinny, I'd like that. So I lost all this weight. Suddenly I was what I wanted to be, what I thought I wanted to be, which was thin. And I hated my body more than anything else. It took me so long after I lost all the weight to really just accept that this is what my body looks like now, and that it may change, that I may be able to get healthier and work out. But this is what my body looks like now, and I need to accept that or I can't work. My body might not change, and I still love my job, and I'm still gonna do it regardless. I'm still gonna get naked no matter how skinny I get, you know? Accepting that, and accepting that I needed to stop being so damn mean to myself about my body in general, like no matter what it looked like, changed my entire life. Like, made me a much happier person, much more content, not just with my job. So that That's cool.